Greetings, campers. Welcome to another Halloween edition of the Geek Garage. Today I'll be traveling down to Camp Crystal Lake to do a long-awaited review of the Tom Savini Jason Voorhees COVID mask. But before we gather on the campfire, go ahead and smash that subscribe button like it's a head frozen in liquid nitrogen. As an avid horror fan and practical effects geek, Tom Savini is naturally someone I've been a fan of for a really long time. He's written a couple books on how to do your own special effects makeup, and he's worked on so many movies I can't even list them all here, but needless to say, he's earned his title as the Sultan of Splatter. Now, while locked up during quarantine, my friends and I were playing the Friday the 13th video game on PlayStation almost nightly. It was a great way to reconnect with each other while remaining socially distanced and responsible. We had such a blast doing it, it was a great time. I highly recommend the game, even if it is plagued with bugs, hackers, and its creators have all but abandoned it, I definitely recommend checking it out. So when we heard that Tom Savini was releasing special edition Jason COVID masks, I knew that I had to get one. I thought it'd be a great way to commemorate like a really weird, bizarre time hanging out with my friends online. We couldn't hang out with each other in real life, and I thought it'd be a cool way to pick up a collectible by one of my favorite effects artists. Now, that was back in May when I placed the order, and it just now arrived, so I'll start my review with the shipping issues. To order a mask, you had to DM Jason Baker on Instagram or Twitter, and he would send you instructions on how to place an order. His message stated that each mask is handcrafted, and therefore a 2-week delivery time should be expected. But the weeks slipped by, and still no mask arrived. All attempts to message Jason went unanswered. The Instagram posts had comments disabled, and people online began to wonder if this was legit or just a giant scam. Eventually, Baker began posting about production delays. He even included an email address you can contact to find out the status of your order. After a month went by, I messaged them to find out what was going on with my mask, and they added an additional 3 to 6 week delivery time. Then on August 8th, an email went out telling everyone it was going to be another 3 to 4 weeks before it would be delivered. Now, by this time, Twitter was ablaze with outrage. Tweets complained about the delays and how some people who ordered in June received their masks, while people who ordered in May were still empty-handed. There was even an account created where people could just go to complain about their masks and their orders. On top of all this, the quality of the latest batch of masks, like Jason, had gone to hell. Some were so bad that they belonged at the bottom of Crystal Lake. If I'd got one of these, I would have felt as ripped off as somebody watching Part 5 for the first time, expecting Jason but getting Roy. Spoiler alert. I kept telling my friend I would rather wait additional time to get a mask that looks like the one that I ordered than getting a low quality one delivered tomorrow. And lo and behold, my long wait paid off and the quality was excellent. So now I'll get into the review of the actual mask. All right, enough of my babbling, let's talk about the mask. My first impression is that the quality is very high. It's a really hard molded plastic. It's nice and thick. And these snaps on here are actual metal. They're not plastic painted chrome or anything. Speaking of paint, the paint job on it looks incredible. I'm really happy with how this turned out. It doesn't look like the crappy summer ones that had the runny mascara eye and the really bad drips coming out of the holes. These actually look like an old aged mask. And these ones actually have that dirty effect put onto it. There's a little bit of a misting of kind of like this dirt color on it. The summer ones looked a little too clean for me. It looked like they were skipping that step, but I'm glad to see that they brought it back. Although it might've just been not showing up in people's photos, but from pictures on Twitter, it looked like they didn't even have this. Overall, the paint job looks awesome. As you can see, I opted for the signed edition. Now I'll talk about the pricing of the two different versions at the end of the video. The straps on here are a very high quality, thick nylon strap. And if you're worried about the sizing, don't worry because there's plenty of strap. It's very long, almost too long. We'll see when I try it on, but there's two straps on here and each has a really thick, hard, heavy duty parachute buckle on it. So these are good quality. These aren't gonna crack or break on you. The COVID mask. Now it's a double layer cotton mask. There's not much to it. There's no pocket for N95s or anything. There's Velcro pieces on here so you can take it out if you're gonna wash it. My one notice is that like, the Velcro is kind of sewn on poorly. There's just like one stripe of stitching in the middle and these sides are kind of out flapping and they didn't go fully around the whole square. These might eventually tear off. So that might be an issue. Again, I'm buying this more as a collectible, so that won't really be a big deal because I'm not gonna be wearing it every day. It's mostly gonna sit on my shelf, but let's try it on and see how it fits. All right, so this is like the Hannibal Lecter style. Let's put this on here. All right. Wow, it's actually surprisingly comfortable. I didn't expect that. The mold is actually contoured very well for your face. There's no parts where anything's rubbing up against any skin or anything's pinching, so that's good. Depending how tight you have it, breathing isn't too bad. Obviously, if it's a little bit looser, you can breathe a little better. The cotton fabric on the inside feels really soft and comfortable against your skin, so that's good, especially if it's just a quick trip to the grocery store. There's nothing too uncomfortable about it. It is a little bulky, so if you don't mind that, that's fine. But again, I'm not gonna wear this as a COVID mask. I was getting it for a collectible on my shelf, but that's something to be aware of. As I did fear, these straps are a little long and kind of flopping around on your face. But once you size it up, you can always cut these and make them a little shorter. Just make sure, because they're nylon, after you cut them, make sure that you melt them. Otherwise, they're gonna fray and fall apart. But yeah, overall, I'm very happy with how it fits. I was actually kind of surprised. I thought it was gonna be very uncomfortable and bulky, but fits pretty good. The straps aren't slipping, so the design on that aspect is pretty solid. All right, let's talk about the price. But first, I just want to say I was not paid for this review, and I spent my own money in order to buy this mask. Now, just the mask costs $60, or $80 if you're ordering internationally, and a signed mask costs $100, or $120 if you're ordering internationally. Now, they started selling these at the beginning of the pandemic, so I reached out to see if this was going towards any sort of COVID relief or charity, and I never got a response back, so I can only assume that it's not. But needless to say, they sold so many masks, they probably made more money than the budget of the first Friday the 13th movie. One thing that they didn't mention when I inquired about ordering is that you can actually get different designs if you want. So you don't have to get just a plain Jason mask. You can actually get the Roy version, which has blue stripes on the side, or the Nintendo version, which is a neon purple and blue color. So there's a lot of design options, which is pretty cool. All right, time for my final thoughts. Now, with the 6-month shipping delay and the poor communication, this purchase was almost a critical miss. But when the mask showed up, I was very pleased with the level of quality, and I was honestly quite surprised after I saw what was shipping out this summer. But having said that, I really shouldn't be giving bonus points for delivering the product that you're supposed to deliver, so for that reason, this review barely squeaks by with a successful roll. Now, if you enjoyed this video, go ahead and slash that like button, and if you want to see some photos of the mask, check out the official Geek Garage Instagram page. Remember, stay safe, wear a mask, and I'll see you at Camp Blood. Geek, geek.